Hi, Dr. Gallagher.
Hello, how are you?
I'm great, thanks. So, Dr. Gallagher, who are you and what do you do?
I actually have a lot of jobs. So one of my jobs, I'm a professor at a university and I teach physics and astronomy. I teach university students about space and about how the world works. And I have a second job that's really cool where I'm the science advisor to the Canadian Space Agency. And that means I give the Canadian Space Agency advice on the best science that we can possibly do with all of our space missions.
That's super cool. So what are you working on at the Canadian Space Agency?
The Canadian Space Agency is involved in tons of different projects. So we have some science experiments on the International Space Station. We also have satellites in space that do all sorts of things. They look down on the Earth and they take beautiful pictures of the Earth so we can map all of the different land. And we also have satellites that are looking out into the distant universe and very far, far away. One of the ones we're most excited about is the James Webb Space Telescope, which is going to launch later this year.
The James Webb Space Telescope? What's that?
So, what happens is when the light travels through our atmosphere, it actually gets smeared around and we can't take really great pictures of outer space. So instead, we send telescopes outside of the atmosphere and far away so that they can take great pictures of space. The James Webb Space Telescope is a NASA telescope, but Canada has two instruments on it. And that means that we also get to use this telescope to look at things like other planets, really far away galaxies, black holes, all sorts of really cool stuff.
Wow, so cool. You must use the electromagnetic spectrum all the time. Can you tell us about it?
So the electromagnetic spectrum is light, but light has lots and lots of different colors and lots of different energies. So there's the light that we can see with our eyes, which is just a tiny part of the electromagnetic spectrum.
Huh.
So you know the rainbow, red, orange, yellow, green, blue, violet, that's visible light that we can see with our eyes. But there's light that we can't see with our eyes that tells us a lot about other things in the universe. So things that are really hot give off really energetic light, so ultraviolet light and even x-rays, and things that are cold give off lower energy light, like infrared light. And that's what you see with night vision goggles. We can't see it with our eyes, but we have special cameras that can capture that light.
What kind of things do you think we'll be using it for in the future?
Astronomers are always going to want to use light to learn about other things in the universe. What we want to do, usually, is look at things that are farther away and fainter in order to learn more about them. So that's why we keep building new kinds of telescopes, because we want to be able to look farther and look at things that are fainter. So the James Webb Space Telescope is going to allow us to look at the very first galaxies in the universe.
Awesome.
But you know what? We want to see the very first stars in the universe. And for that, we're going to actually need a bigger telescope that's more sensitive. And so every time we learn more about the universe, we learn about more things that we want to learn more about. And we're going to need different kinds of telescopes in order to figure that out.
What is some advice that you give to young people like me who are interested in STEAM?
I would say that if you're curious about the world, then that is a really big part of being excited at becoming a scientist. You want to be really curious about the world, and you also want to pay attention to it. So you need to notice things, because astronomers are primarily observers. We go and we look. We can't do experiments in the lab. We do experiments by looking at the universe and seeing what's out there. And so you need to pay attention and you need to be really curious.
Dr. Gallagher, thanks so much for speaking with me today.
Thanks so much for having me. Those were awesome questions and I always love talking about astronomy and space.
Bye.